Hello, my name is Ishan Ali. I work for Kinfolk in Berlin, and today I'm going to demonstrate a new feature of Habitat command line interface that allows you to deploy an existing Habitat application on a Kubernetes cluster. First, we need to build a Habitat application. I just chose a sample, one of the example plans for this demo, and we will just build that. Application building takes quite some time, even if it's a very simple application in this case. For the sake of this demo, I have reduced the output and have changed the duration of this command. The build command actually took much longer, but that's not the point of this demo, so I have shortened it. So we go straight to the real part of this demo, which is to export the Habitat package. And we do that now. We also want to push the Docker image so that Kubernetes cluster can access it. Then once you have pushed it, so then you can access it from any Kubernetes cluster. It doesn't have to be local. We give it a name of the hard file that we created with the build process, and now it's getting exported. The Docker image is now being uploaded. Even the uploading also took much longer, now we have video pause. Now we have the Docker image built, and it's been uploaded, so we can now deploy it in Kubernetes cluster. But before we deploy it, we need to run the Habitat operator for. As you can see, it registered the CRD. It was already registered, but it's now running operator, and it will take care of any Habitat apps that run within the Kubernetes cluster, this cluster. We are running, as you can see, the operator is running outside the cluster. For the sake of this demo, that was the simplest thing to do, so I'm running it outside. We look at the output that was created by the Kubernetes exporter command line interface, before I pass the path that I wanted the manifest file in, and that's what we are looking at right now. You see the kind is Habitat for this manifest, we already registered that CRD, so it should be fine, and we can go on and deploy this in the cluster. So we will do that. We apply the manifest, and then it got deployed. As you see, there's a message from the operator. It says created deployment. It found the new resource that was deployed, and it found it as a as a Habitat resource, so it takes care of it. We want to check if the pod is actually running. If the pod is actually running, yeah, as you can see, it's already been started and it's running. We want to look at the log and see which port it's running on, listening to, and it's 8000. And if you want to use that from outside the cluster, we need to set up the port forwarding, and that's what we are going to do here. So we give it the port name, which is same, and it's 8000 port. Now we have set up the port forwarding, put it in background, and then we use a command line web browser to test it, and you can see here that we got the page the only page it serves. It's just a simple test step, and it displays hello world. So it's up and running, and we saw that clients can connect to it and you can use the service. So that was all. Thanks for watching.